Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hello everyone, welcome back to the PL-300 exam preparation series where we are going to explore the practice questions. Since the last video on the practice questions, these are the topics that we have covered. So most of these topics are related to the visualization part and then the last learning path, which is related to Power BI service. So the topics which are related to the visualization include incorporate the Q&A feature in a report, use AI visuals, create and share scorecards and metrics, configure export of report content and perform an export, design report for mobile devices, use the analyze in Excel feature, identify poorly performing measures, relationships and visuals by using the performance analyzer. So these are some of the topics that require changes in the desktop environment and are related to the visualization. And then once you actually publish your report to the Power BI service, then the rest of the topics are mainly related to the Power BI service and relate to the data governance and how you manage your assets in Power BI service. So these topics include create and configure a workspace, assign workspace roles, configure and update a workspace app, publish, import or update assets in a workspace, create dashboards, choose a distribution method, select a shared data set or create a local data set, apply sensitivity labels to workspace content, configure subscriptions and data alerts, promote or certify Power BI content, manage global options for files, identify when a gateway is required, configure a data set scheduled refresh, implement row-level security roles, configure row-level security group membership, and provide access to datasets. Before I actually go to the practice questions, there are some important points that you need to remember and some steps that you need to practice as well. So in the videos, we talked about the on-premises data gateway, but I did not go into the details of installing a data gateway. Although a data gateway is not required to be installed and the questions related to the data gateway on the PL-300 exam are mainly on the scenarios where a data gateway is required, but I would still strongly recommend that you go and set up an on-premises data gateway as per the process explained in the video. Just go and install the data gateway and then use it and practice it in some of your data set examples. Then the last thing that is important is to configure a scheduled refresh. So we saw the whole process where actually the scheduling of a data set can be done inside the Power BI service, but I would strongly recommend that once you install your gateway, then do configure a scheduled refresh by setting up the options which are required inside the Power BI service. So this is going to be a good example of how you can schedule a refresh, and you will understand that how the gateway and the scheduled refresh process works in tandem. So let's now start with the practice question. So we are going to see the practice questions related to the last part of this course, and this is related to the data visualization as well as the Power BI service part. So let's start with question number one. You have a data set named pens that contains the following columns: unit price and quantity ordered. You need to create a visualization that shows the relationship between unit price and quantity ordered. The solution must highlight orders that have a similar unit price and order quantity. Which type of visualization and which feature should you use? So we have two answer areas and we have three options for each answer area. So the first answer area is related to the visualization, and the choices are a column chart of quantity ordered and unit price by year, a line chart of quantity ordered and unit price by item, a scatter plot of quantity ordered and unit price by item. And the second one is feature, which actually has again three options: automatically find clusters, explain the degrees, find where the distribution is different. So let's have a look at the correct answer. So the correct answer is that for the visualization, we are going to use a scatter plot of quantity ordered and unit price by item. And for the feature, we are going to use the automatically find clusters features, which is associated with the scatter plot. So if you have a look at the visualization, so the first thing that you need to keep in mind is that we are actually trying to establish some kind of a relationship between two measures. So the first measure is unit price and the second one is quantity ordered. So in the videos, we actually We covered this in quite a lot of detail, that the only visualization that covers the relationship between two measures is a scatter plot, because you have one measure on the one axis and the other measure on the second axis. And secondly, once you plot this, then you can, in the question where it is asked that you want to highlight the orders that have similar price and quantity, so you can actually find the clusters, and this property is obviously associated with the scatter plot. So that is why the scatter plot and automatically finding the clusters is the right answer to this question. Question 6. You need to provide a user with the ability to add members to a workspace. The solution must use the principle of least privilege. Which role should you assign to the user? The four options are viewer, admin, contributor, and member. So let's have a look at the correct answer. So the correct answer to this question is option D, which is member. So the member and admin role can provide a user with the ability to add members to a workspace. But as the question said that we wanted to use the principle of least privilege, so we can assign the user a member role, because this is the least privilege role which can actually actually provides the ability to add members to a workspace. Although admin can also do that, but it does not fulfill this particular criteria of the principle of least privilege. So that is why option D, member, is the correct answer to this question. Question 9. You have a collection of reports for the HR department of your company. The data sets uses row level security. The company has multiple sales region. Each sales region has an HR manager. You need to ensure that the HR managers can interact with the data from their region only. The HR managers must be prevented from changing the layout of the reports. How should you provision access to the reports for the HR managers? So the four choices that are given to us, and we have to select one, is publish the report in an app and grant the HR managers access permission. Create a new workspace, copy the data sets and reports, and add the HR managers as members of the report of the workspace. Publish the reports to a different workspace other than the one hosting the data sets. Add the HR managers as members of the existing workspace that hosts the reports and the data sets. So let's have a look at the correct answer. So the correct answer for this one is option A, which says publish the reports in an app and grant the HR managers access permission. So here we can see that the requirement that has been given to us, and the critical requirement here, is that the HR managers can interact with the data from their region only, and the HR managers must be prevented from changing the layout of the report. So this is a very important requirement, and based on the choices that are given, the publishing an app and granting access to the HR managers is the correct option for this particular case. So if you make them members, or even if you create another workspace and make those members, all of those actually give the permissions to the HR managers where they can go and change the layout of the report, because these are the permissions which are inherited as a member of a workspace. But if you publish an app and you grant a permission, then these things which are mentioned here in this particular line of the question, these are fulfilled. So the option which is the publishing the report in an app and granting the HR managers access permission is the correct answer to this question. Question 10. You have a Microsoft Power BI data model that contains three tables named orders, date, and city. There is a one-to-many relationship between date and orders and between city and orders. The model contains two row-level security roles named role 1 and role 2. Role 1 contains the following filter, where the filter is that state province column of the city table is equal to Kentucky, and the role 2 contains the following filter, where calendar year column of the date table is equal to 2020. If a user is a member of both role 1 and role 2, what data will they see in a report that uses the model? So the four options that are available to us, and we have to select one, are: the user will see the data for which the state province value is Kentucky, or where the calendar year is 2020. The user will receive an error and will not be able to see the data in the report. The user will only see data for which the state province value is Kentucky. The user will only see data for which the state province value is Kentucky and the calendar year is 2020. So let's have a look at the correct answer to this question. And the correct answer to this question is option A, which says the user will see data for which the state province value is Kentucky or where the calendar year is 2020. So if you have a scenario like a scenario where we have two different roles, then the overall effect is an additive effect. So if you have an additive effect, then the user will see the data for which the state province value is Kentucky, which is defined by this filter, or where the calendar year is 2020. So this additive effect can be seen in role level security if we have two roles like role 1 and role 2. So there is, if you look in the content, there is a specific video that just explains this particular property of role level security, and this is actually based on the video that is related to the role level security that I have just mentioned. So this question is actually working on the same principle, which is the additive principle associated with the role level security. Question 11. You have a Power BI data model that contains a table named employees. The table has the following columns: employee name, email address, start date, and job title. So these are the four columns. You are implementing dynamic role level security. You need to create a table filter to meet the following requirements. Users must see only their own employee data. The DAX expression must work in both Power BI desktop and the Power BI service. Which expression should you use? And the four expressions that are given to us are these one: email address is equal to username, employee name is equal to user principal name, employee name is equal to username, and email address is equal to user principal name. So let's have a look at the correct answer to this question. And the correct answer to this question is email address is equal to user principal name. So we have actually seen this in detail once in the video where we were talking about dynamic row level security. And we saw this function user principal name, and we saw that it works both in Power BI desktop and in Power BI service. And obviously the users are only able to see their own employee data. So option D is the correct answer to this question. Question 12. You need to create a Power BI workspace that meets the following requirements. Must support a data set that has size of 2 GB. Must notify 3 non-administrative users when issue occur in the workspace. Which two settings should you change when you create the workspace? So we have to actually pick two settings out of these four options to fulfill the requirements for this question. And the options are contact list, license mode, data flow storage, and workspace OneDrive. Let's look at the correct answer for this question. And the correct answer is contact list and license mode. So here, if you look at the first requirement, which says that the data set has a size of 2 GB. So obviously that is only possible if you change the license mode to premium. So the first thing that you need to change is that you need to make sure that the license mode is premium, because the pro can only support a maximum size data model or data set size of 1 GB. And then the other area where you can notify the non-administrative users is the contact list. So if you have the email addresses of the people in the contact list, then obviously this is the other area in the workspace that you need to actually go and make the changes. So these two options are the correct answer to this particular question.